whereas Arjuna Prabhu is so wonderfully showing and performing kirtan, it should always be done with enthusiasm. It should be done with excitement. With determination. A wonderful example that I wanted to share of Srila Prabhupada's own excitement is portrayed in this wonderful story from Govinda Dasi's book, A Place of Sandalwood and Roses. It's about Srila Prabhupada, and this is a chapter called Drums from Goloka. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Can we take the talking outside, please? Big boxes of cymbals and drums arrive from India. Delighted, almost like a child on Christmas morning, Swamiji squats down by the boxes and carefully inspects each one. Mukunda and Haridas carefully pry open each box, gently lifting the drums from their resting place inside. Swamiji scrutinizes each one, examining the drum heads for possible damage. I can say from experience that many of us who play mridanga, we have this same experience whenever we get a new mridanga or we receive a new mridanga shipped from India. It is like Christmas, and when we open it, immediately we're inspecting it's made the journey safely, and that there's no issues with it, and then we're so excited to play it for the first time. So, satisfied, he immediately begins to play. Several more devotees enter quietly, eager to hear more about these mysterious drums. At this point in the movement, no one had even seen a mridanga, heard one, or knew what this instrument was called. Kitata, 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 kita. An incredible sound fills the room. It is a sound not heard from any other instrument. The devotees are mesmerized by Swamiji's expert drumming. He is obviously delighted and absorbed in some other world, not yet known to his handful of disciples. The Swami smiles and says, "These drums, they are called mridangas. They are designed by Krishna himself." He plays a few more clever beats so quickly and expertly, the devotees gasp in surprise. Yes, Swamiji beams. These drums are meant especially for this Sankirtan movement, for chanting Hare Krishna, for Nam Sankirtan. His eyes twinkle and grow wide with delight. With a slight movement of his eyebrows, he adds, "They come from the spiritual world." He continues to play the drum for a few minutes more. Kitata, 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 kita. "Very good sound," he exclaims, quite satisfied. "They give the sweetest sound. This sound cannot be made by any other drum in this world because it is transcendental." Even in Goloka, Lord Chaitanya plays these drums, mridanga, with his Sankirtan party. He beams with joy and continues to play the drum with tapping fingers. His fingers snap against the drum head so quickly the devotees can hardly see their pattern of movement. After some time, he rises slowly and carefully, hugging the drum to his chest, and walks to his room. There he continues to tap the drum in many different rhythms for the rest of the day. Srila Prabhupada ki? Mridanga drum ki? So as we can see from this wonderful story, it's important to maintain a childlike excitement when it comes to doing kirtan, when it comes to playing these transcendental instruments. for the service of the kirtan and for the pleasure of Lord Chaitanya and Srila Prabhupada. Krishna, 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 Hare Krishna, Krishna,
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.